challenge for this week, we talked about Poisson's equation in two dimensions, and we showed that that led to a matrix that had very, very characteristic structure. If instead we did Poisson's equation in one dimension, for example, if instead of having a membrane, we had a string where some kind of wave hit the string and we wanted to look at displacement, then we would end up with a tridiagonal matrix. Okay, what's a tridiagonal matrix? It's a matrix where you only have the diagonal, the subdiagonal, and the superdiagonal. Now, you would think that there are enough zeros in this matrix that one should be able to take advantage of it. So therefore, maybe this is a sparse matrix. Well, let's think about this. Well, through some homework, you're going to discover that not only is this matrix symmetric, but it's actually symmetric positive definite. And here we're just going to, for the moment, give up on complex values. Let's just stay with real numbers. Now, what did we learn about factoring symmetric positive definite matrices? Well, we learned that we can deploy the Kolesky factorization for that. And how would that algorithm work? Well, that algorithm would partition our matrix and would then take the square root right here, would divide that square root into this number, and then would do an outer product of that with itself transposed to update the rest of the matrix. And if we forgot about the fact that there are a whole bunch of zeros sitting here, then the cost of that would be 1/3 n cubed, where n is the number of rows and columns here. So through a homework, you're going to see that indeed, if this matrix is sparse like this, if it's only a tridiagonal matrix, then the cost of Kolesky factorization can be greatly reduced. It's still a direct method because we're going through a specific number of operations at the end of which we have our answer, but it now takes advantage of the very special sparsity structure of this matrix.